thank all of you for tuning in. Your soul is so grateful and so thankful that you tuned in today, that you can now once again embrace yourself and get a real sense of the love of God that's operating through you right now, saying to yourself every day in every way, I am elevating my awareness. Every day in every way, I'm expanding my consciousness. Every day in every way, I am remembering my soul call. Every day in every way, I am surrendering to my great destiny. You begin to speak to yourself like that. Sometimes when you speak to yourself, you tear yourself down. And you want to embrace the capital S self within you and let it run free throughout your entire life. So that your time on the planet is a time in which the timeless gets to erupt into time, bringing the gifts, the talents, and the capacities that are within you on earth as it is in the mind of the infinite. You are here to set yourself free. The theme of the month, of course, is your rise and shine agreement. And I've been reminding you these past few weeks that when you leaped into your human incarnation, you knew already the vicissitudes and the trials and tribulations that were happening on planet Earth and that would be happening during this time in human history. You knew already that there was a paradigm that is descending and becoming decadent, that is no longer in cadence with the thrust of the evolutionary energy that's coming forward. It is decadent. And you know there's a cadence of harmonizing good, a new paradigm that's being birthed. You know, the old paradigm of grab and get and consumerism, the old paradigm of non-renewable resources and things of that particular nature is slowly fading out, and a new paradigm is being born at this time in human history, and we're in the middle of the death throes and the midwifing and the birth of a new paradigm. And that particular state of consciousness is called confusion. Confusion is a very high state of consciousness because you're simultaneously holding both dynamics at the same time, the death of one and the birth of another. But you who are listening to this message are beginning to articulate that which is seeking to emerge, and you're catching it through dream, you're catching it through vision. It's invisible to most, but not to you who have spiritual practice, not to you who are visioning, not to you who are affirmatively praying, not to you who are meditating, not to you who are going into the sacred silences of your own soul and catching the sweet, sweet whisperings of the Spirit that you begin to hear on a soulular level, so that you begin to see, not with eyes, but with your heart, that something beautiful is trying to be born at this time in human history. I'm here to remind you that you took a vow before you entered into this domain, and that vow, excuse me, was to rise and shine. What does that mean? Rising means lifting your vibration. It means though there's density of thought forms, though there's confusion that lends itself to worry and doubt and fear, and though there are dense thought forms that are clouding people's perceptions, you're here to engage in your spiritual practice so that you're rising, you're lifting your frequency, and then holding that dynamic, and then shining. Shining means sharing. Shining means radiating. Shining means giving of your talents, gifts, and capacities that are within you, so that you're literally, metaphorically, and spiritually, you're living to share and shine and give of yourself. That you're not locked up and contracted in getting and taking and hoarding and protecting. No, that does not become your primary mode of being in the world. Your primary mode of being in the world is, I'm here to share, I'm here to shine, I'm here to glow. And when you do that, you come in harmony with the fundamental laws of the universe, and you begin to discover that the presence of God is for you and not against you, and you break free from the limiting points of view that have people living in fear, doubt, and worry as a normal state of consciousness. Not you. Not here, not now. You are coming to be able to answer this question, which is the topic of the day. Just what are you stabilizing? Insights or something else? Now remember, your constant thoughts become repetitive and cyclical, and they create perception. And that perception then creates your experience. And so you want to look at what you're stabilizing in your life. Fear, doubt, and worry, lack, limitation, not enoughness, a sense of protectionism, a sense of contraction around the circumstances that are going on in the world. Or are you stabilizing insights? Now, through spiritual practice, now this is why our community, one of the reasons why our community is here. Our community is here so that people come in, they come into the field of agape, and the first layer that happens in the field is a level of healing. It's a level of embracing the woundedness that individuals have had in their human incarnation, and to allow that to be healed to a great degree so that ultimately individuals are able to stabilize themselves at a higher frequency, not around their woundedness, not around their interpretation of the past and what has happened to them, but they're stabilizing their awareness around the fundamental idea of unity with the power and the presence and the love of God. Oneness with God, emanation of God, not separate from a deity that comes and goes, that's reluctant, that's sometimey. But an awareness that the presence of God is closer than our breathing and nearer than our hands and feet. A real awareness around this. We learn to stabilize around that so that we can then shine and give our gifts like never before. You are here to stabilize that. But you have to look at yourself honestly, and you have to see where you have stabilized yourself. Because remember those thought forms? Those thought forms that you have become perception. Cyclical, repetitive, become perception. Now, perception produces experience. Now, perception doesn't create reality. Perception creates your experience of reality. Most people don't have an experience of reality. They only have an experience of their thoughts about reality. And so your role as a spiritual practitioner, an individual that's practicing these fundamental universal principles, is to have an encounter with the divine presence that sets you free from the limited point of view so that you begin to live in a dynamic of freedom, of liberation, a dynamic of the feeling tone that all is well, the dynamic of the feeling tone that all of your needs are met, the dynamic of the feeling tone that you're one with God, and that you proclaiming their oneness with God does not diminish God, it magnifies God. It multiplies God. The wave doesn't diminish the ocean. It is what the ocean does. The ocean waves. The sunbeam doesn't diminish the sun. It is how the sun is expressing through the beam. You do not diminish God by saying, my life is the life of God. You're magnifying the Lord, the great law of life, according to your unique pattern, according to your uniqueness that will never exist again, because the presence of God doesn't repeat itself, because it is infinite. So you will be the only you that ever exists. And as you've heard me say over the years, if you don't do you, you won't be done. And so you are here to stabilize a much higher frequency. Now here's the question. Do you have a thought, or does a thought have you? You got to answer that question. There's a thought, have you? Because right now we're living in a time where there's a health emergency. We're living in a time where we're bombarded every single day about the latest info about the virus, the latest info about what's going on. And it comes with an underlying fear-based frequency. And oftentimes, if you don't have spiritual practice, then that thought grabs you, hijacks your mind, and before you know it, you're living contracted in fear, doubt, and worry, and that thought has you. And as you keep going back to the news, you know it cycles itself. It doesn't. It gives you the same news two or three times a day. And I'm not saying you don't look at the news. I'm saying you look at it. You get the latest information. You don't let the thought grab you. Because there's a difference between you having a thought or a thought having you. Most people believe that when a thought has them, they believe that's thinking. That's not thinking. Thinking is called inspiration. Thinking is when the mind of God and its creative urgency grabs your awareness and a new thought. This is why we call this new thought ageless wisdom, because a new thought emerges through you. It's called inspiration. It's called creativity. It's called resourcefulness. It's called innovativeness. This is called new thought. We ought to have one every now and then. Every now and then, there must be a new thought, a moment of inspiration, but you're not going to get inspiration if you're vibrating down at the frequency of contraction and fear and doubt and worry and lack and limitation and not enoughness. No, 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 no. And so listen to me right now. Listen to what I'm listening to and come to an understanding that you are to now come into real thinking. Now, real thinking happens when you meditate. When you affirmatively pray, when you affirm the truth of your being, you extricate your mind that's been hijacked by thoughts that are grabbing you, and you become a candidate for a rich insight. What you formerly believed, you now begin to know. What is it that you believe? You believe there's only one God, one power, one presence that's everywhere in its fullness. You believe you're one with this presence. You believe this presence is not capricious, jealous, or out to get you. You don't believe that this presence, which is love, has an original sin ethic within you, or is going to send you to some eternal place called hell or some nonsense like that. It's been passed down through the ages. No, 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 no. You, somewhere within your heart, believe that God is love. And the love presence is totally giving of itself, totally and completely at every point in this magnificent universe. However, believing is just the beginning. That's the beginning step. The next step is practice what you believe. That means you have to pray. You have to meditate. You have to vision. You have to serve until the insight around what you believe begins to be more real than the evidence that your physical eyes are giving you. Your physical eyes are letting you hear what Jesus meant when he said that the poor will be with us always. He wasn't talking just necessarily about financially poor. He was talking about poor in consciousness. Individuals whose perception was so limited that fear, doubt, and worry and the security ethic was way more important than the delivery of their giftedness. You'll begin to expand yourself from that awareness. Now, here's the deal. When, in fact, a thought has you, you don't have a thought, when the thought grabs you, you begin to live in the field of what you do not want to happen in your life. That becomes your primary point of view. I don't want this. I don't want to get sick. I don't want COVID. I don't want to be broke. I don't want these bad things to happen to my family. I don't want these bad things to happen to my loved ones. And here's the deal. Nothing comes into your experience uninvited. Everything comes into your experience because you unconsciously invited, because the law does not know the difference between what you want and don't want. It only knows what you're interested in. And so if you're interested more in what you don't want, then you're using the law in reverse. And you are inviting what you don't want into your experience. Even if that experience doesn't literally happen, you still produce the toxic chemicals emanating from the frequency of fear. I don't want negativity. I don't want to be hurt. I don't want, I don't want, I don't want. And then the mind produces the toxic chemicals that move through the body and deplete. Cortisol moves through the body and depletes your immune system, creates a discoherent frequency around the brain. You can't think clearly. You go into a lower fog, a lower fear, lower worry, and you stabilize yourself around the lower frequency of merely protectionism rather than expression of the good that's trying to happen through you. Not here, not now, not you. You did not tune into this particular freedom station to stay the same. You did not tune into this liberating message for you to have a palliative anemic message about God loving you. You tuned into this particular field of liberation that you may become a practitioner of these sacred truths so that your life will change and that you will glow and grow from a glory to an even glory on a regular basis, so that month after month, year after year, you're becoming more empowered, more focused, more strong, more vital, more vigorous. You are able to embrace yourself and say, oh my God, there's so much good within me. Listen to me. You know that you are a spiritual being. Spiritual and eternal mean the same thing. You know you're a cosmic being. Do you know what that means? Let me break it down for you. The undifferentiated wholeness, that which has never even manifested yet, which is way more infinite than anything that's ever manifest, that's called the cosmos. K-O-S-M-O-S. That's the cosmos with the K. And then there's the cosmos with the C. That's everything that's manifested. That's the galaxies, the multidimensional universes, the solar systems, all that we can see from something massive to a small quark. That's the manifest realm, even though it is big and expanding. Now check this out, cosmic being. All of that is within you. You are a holographic expression. Holograph means the seeming part carries the whole. You are a holographic expression of all of that. Tied yourself in a little knot. Oh, I'm nothing. I'm little. I'm insignificant. Oh, my God. My parents, they did it to me. They left. They should have left. They left, but they should have left. They didn't leave, but they should have left. Oh, whatever. Listen, we know what happens when you go into that realm. You use your creativity to make excuses for why you're not happy, why you're not in joy, why you're not empowered. Not today. You are a cosmic being, and you want to untie your knots. I'm not good enough. I'm not enough. You see, you would untie all those little knots within you and begin to understand that as a cosmic being, via practice, that allows you to stabilize your insights, you start to walk in freedom. Yes, it'll seem a bit odd in the beginning because your mind has stabilized itself around survival. And there's nothing wrong with survival. We want to survive. Yes, we do. But you're more than a survivalist. You're more than an individual who just wants to survive. Wait, survive for what? You're just eating some food, using toilet tissue, going to the bathroom, just surviving? No. You are here to survive so that you can deliver your giftedness. You can deliver the love operating in your heart, the generosity, the creativity. You want to survive with a purpose, you see? And so you want to stabilize around a higher frequency. Now, when I say to you life is good, what does that bump up against? I mean, just look, this is not judgment. This is not a judgment exercise. None of this. None of this is judgment. It's all awareness. But once you become aware of the habitual thought patterns, you become aware of them, your awareness itself transmutes them so that you can transcend them. Most people are operating from unconscious thoughts that have been planted there by society or other people or misinterpretation of a past experience. And so they're living from unconsciousness. So when I say life is good, and what does it bump up against? What do you mean life is good? Life is hard until you die. What are you talking about life is good? It's a struggle. Oh, my God, no, life isn't good. It's not enough to go around. Oh, it's terrible out here. Oh, there's COVID. There's this. There's that. There's all this stuff going on. What is he talking about? Life is good. Just look at the thought without judgment. And if that thought and that thought form is not in harmony with the spiritual principle, what is the spiritual principle? Oneness. Unity with the presence of God. Not a man in the sky, but a presence that's not an absence. And that presence is love, beauty, intelligence, and more. If that thought is not in harmony with that, then that thought is a lie and the father of more lies. It creates tributaries of more lies, of which becomes your perception, of which becomes your experience. You hold your destiny in your own mouth. Blessing or curse about what comes out of your mouth via what you are holding as thought forms. Sometimes you start with just checking out what's coming out of your mouth. What are you saying? What are you saying about other people? You think if you're talking about somebody that has no effect of you, oh no, it's coming out of you first. That venom, that carcinogenic, cancerous stuff coming out of your mouth about someone else, it's coming out of you first. You don't want to ever say what you don't want to experience. But then you start going back further. You start doing spiritual practice, and before it comes out of the mouth, you look at what the mind is thinking. Ooh, where did that thought come from? A thought had me. I was about to say something that was going to be debilitating to my own immune system. Oh, no! after a while, you're able to nip it in the bud. I can remember a number of years ago, I used to do these long, intensive meditations. And I can remember, this is pre-Agape, and I had the time to do it, you know, these 10-day meditation retreats. And I can remember we would get to the point where we would sit in meditation, and we would see a thought emerging in our awareness, and then we would stop it. We could be in this field, this rich field of such great luminosity, and a thought would emerge, and we could snip it out before it became conscious. You see, you will, with practice, start with what's coming out of your mouth. What are you saying about yourself? What are you saying about others? And then you'll be able to, with practice, look at the thought itself. Why am I thinking that about him? Why am I thinking that about her? I might have that perception, but I don't. That's not the truth of them. That's some fact that I got that I don't even know where I got that fact. Did somebody tell me that about her? Did somebody tell me that about him? Did I see it? You remember what was said, and Marvin Gaye made it famous in his song, "You believe half of what you see and none of what you hear." That's so true, baby, because your perception clouds everything. Now, this is the deal. When with individuals without practice, and they become held captive by the thoughts of the world, they generally live in, as I was saying earlier, what I don't want to happen. So they live in this frequency of, I don't want this to happen. I don't want this to happen to my loved ones. I don't want to be broke. I don't want to be sick. I don't want to have a car accident. I don't want my house to be broken into. I don't want to be stolen from. I don't want to. And that becomes their prevailing feeling that they've stabilized around. And so the law is being used in reverse about what you don't want to happen. I want you to begin to articulate what you do want. I want that to become so strong. I want, what did Dr. Thurman say? I want to be a kind and gracious human being. That when I walk into the room, my vibration takes the chill off the room with those in my goings and comings. I want to be a vehicle of such love and compassion. I want to be an opening for dynamic prosperity and abundance. I want to be an instrumentality for creativity and generosity, innovativeness and resourcefulness. I want to be an opening for sacred service. I want to feel the longing of my heart to be more of my real self, my authentic nature. Now, when you begin to proclaim more of what you want than what you don't want, you will stabilize around that high intentionality. That high intentionality will be a new set point for you. Meaning, even when you're not consciously thinking that, it's still operating. You know what that's called? That's called prayer without ceasing, baby. Prayer without ceasing is not standing in the street all the time going, God, no. You know, no, prayer without ceasing means that you've stabilized on a subjective level. You're longing to be consciously connected to the presence that is never an absence. So even as it states in Scripture, even when you think not, whoa, it shows up. It just, we're not even consciously thinking, whoa. Why? Because you're not blocking it now. You're not hindering it with a lie, you see. Now I know this, everything I'm saying here right now is simple. I'm breaking it down very simply. It's not easy. I don't want to leave you with the thought that what I'm saying is easy. Because some of you are going to turn on the news in a little bit. And you're going to listen to the latest stuff that's going on. And your thought might be snatched, might be hijacked. Somebody may call you with some news. Your thought might be hijacked. This is practice, you see. So that, yes, you become informed. Yes, you get the latest news about what's going on. But then you become aware what news is at times. Never, it means never evolving with spirit. Leonard Loomis, one of our practitioners, sent that to me in a text this week. The name for news is never evolving with spirit. In other words, the news is a display of present consciousness. It's a present day expression of the paradigm that we're all living in right now. The poor is with us right now. Fear is with us. Doubt is with us. And, you know. And so, but the gospel or the good news is different. The good news is saying in substance that your life is divine. That you are a magnificent emanation of the Most High. And that with spiritual practice, you can have an insight into that truth and then stabilize it. So the question is, just what are you stabilizing? Insight or something else? This determines your perception and it determines your experience. So let me ask you again. When I say life is good, what does it bump up against? Again, not judgment, just awareness. What thought form does it bump up against? Is that man crazy? Life is good? Is he not watching any news? Is he not seeing any news feed about what's going on in the world? Of course. But I've heard the good news. There shall be trials and tribulations in the world. But be of good cheer. Because I've overcome the world. You see, that's what the teacher said. That Jewish rabbi that was an enlightened being, one of the greatest spiritual geniuses on the planet, said, be of good cheer because I've overcome that world. What is that world? That world is a set of agreements that everyone has agreed upon that produces mass experience. I'm not getting in that world. Are you crazy? I'd rather look like I'm crazy than be crazy, you see. I'd rather look crazy to people in that world than to actually be crazy. Do you know that enlightenment and sanity mean the same thing? But most enlightened people look crazy, you see. Now, here's the deal. I've been teaching this, I'm afraid to say it, for over 40 years. Timeless. The world's now caught up. We got great allies. Joe Dispenza, Bruce Lipton, Greg Braden. Great allies in the scientific realm that are now corroborating what we've been teaching for years. That thought that shifts your perception, creates your experience, your body chemistry, either speeds up or slows down the aging process, impugns or magnifies the immune system. Now the science, which is the new language of mysticism, is saying the exact same thing. So listen, your destiny is up to you. I don't care what your hereditary pattern says, what your DNA says. I'm not concerned about that. I'm concerned about you and your practice. So from this moment on, don't give me a list about what you don't want to happen. You know that mothers are very psychically connected to their kids? And if they worry about what's going to happen to their kids, they help create a little bit of that experience. I'm not trying to call it guilt. I'm trying to call awareness. Fall in love with your kids. Just love them. See great possibilities. Fall in love with your friends. See great possibility. Fall in love with your relatives. See great possibility. We're all connected. What if we overcome the world and see the dawning of a new golden age of great possibility? Renewable resources sharing and shining. We get to imagine whatever we want. Why not re-enchant the imagination rather than letting it be hijacked and running amok with worst-case scenarios? Why not? What's it going to hurt? Nothing. So let me just run this over just a little bit. Let me just start from the beginning. Now you can hear it. You have taken a rise and shine agreement to come to the earth in density with your immensity and bring the eternal into time, to rise and consciously lift your vibration with spiritual practices that cause you to remember who you are and to shine, to share, to give of your talents, gifts, and capacities, and so that your time on the planet is bringing the eternal into time. Just what are you stabilizing? Insights? If you're in spiritual practice, the answer is yes. You're stabilizing insights. You're becoming aware. Does a thought have you, or are you having a thought? If the thought grabs you from the world of fear, doubt, worry, and lack and limitation, that's not called thinking. People believe it is. That's called mentation. The regurgitation, repetitive, cyclical thought forms that create perception and experience. You then live, and I don't want this, I don't want this, I don't want this, I don't want that. No, don't misuse the law of mind and action. Use it properly. I long for a conscious realization of my oneness with life and abundance and joy and wellness and well-being and strength and vitality and vigor and safety and wellness for myself and my family and everyone else. What I desire of my heart is greater vibrationally and frequency than what I don't want. Now I'm on the right use of the law. I'm setting myself free. And that's practice. Remember what I've said recently. Practice doesn't make perfect. It is the practice of perfection that makes perfect. Because many people have practiced worry. Very practiced in doubt, cynicism, skepticism. Very practiced in fear and worry. They've got that down. So it's not just practice makes perfect. It's the practice of perfection that makes perfect. Practice being in love with the presence. Practice being in love with your loved ones from the inside out. Practice being in love with what God has created right here. Practice, practice, practice. Set yourself free. So once again, when I say life is good, when I say life is good, what does it bump up against? Now, we have gone from my living room over 34 years ago. In my living room, we went to the upper room with visioning. And now we're in living rooms all around the world. So we've gone from living room to the upper room to living rooms everywhere. And if you're there in your living room, I see a couple of you in your bedroom, that's okay. Wherever you are, just stand up and start allowing your body to just move so we can have some, you know, serotonin move to the body temple, some oxytocin, some tonic chemicals. We're practicing good cheer here, you see? It's a practice. It's not frivolous. It's not, oh my God, I'm feeling guilty for having a level of joy when there's so much suffering in the world. No! Your joy is the antidote because you think clearly and now you can be generous. Now you can share. Now you can hear the testimony of so many people saying, I'm going shopping for my neighbors. You can be like Jamie, I'm cooking for people. You can begin to shine in ways you have never shone before. Let the music start. You feel that? Just let that body move. This is called Life is Good. It's from the CD Transcendence. It's activated. Life is good and all is well, yes? Life is good and all is well, yes? Do you feel it? Life is good. Do you feel it? And all is well. With a little smile on your face. That's really advanced right there. To smile? Uh-huh. You're already producing tonic chemicals when you smile, even if you don't feel like it.
Life is good. You feel it?
You're a cosmic being!
In you is such a beauty and a power and a love that can never die. It's always Woo. There. It's inviolate.
It's inviolate!
And though it may be covered up by experience temporarily, it's real. And we're here to uncover that destiny and allow it to shine according to our unique patterns as individual expressions of God. So we're gonna go home now.
Are you moving out there?
We're letting go to the
in Agape Nation? Are you? Is the Agape Nation moving? You should be moving by now.
The all-creative spirit.
Don't let me have you dance by myself.
You're all originating a spirit. That is totally.
Just do your own move.
Totally and completely. At every point of the cosmos.
Shake everything out.
Sense of withhold whatsoever. Life is good.
Ain't God something? Ain't God something?
Feel it. Something.
Whatever seeming generation you came from, you gotta move. Oh, she's twerking. That's okay.
Wants to live through you. Do you know who you are? This presence wants to give through you. Do you know who you are?
Do you know who you are?
Wants to sing through you. Do you know who you are?
Do you know?
This presence wants to create through you. Do you know who you are? This presence wants to heal through you. Do you know who you are? Do you know who you are? Then you will assume the receptive posture.
Receptive posture.
The greatness that is trying to happen through you. I'm ready. I'm available.
Yes.
I am open.
Ready. I'm available. I'm open.
This is our moment.
This is our moment.
This is our destiny.
This is our destiny.
It's a wonderful destiny.
Ooh-wee.
God made no mistakes. When
God made no mistakes,
the
baby.
The pattern of delight as you. Do it.
Woo.
Life is good.
Woo. Woo.
Ain't God something?
Ray, ain't God something? Marianne, ain't God something?
Something.
Deanna, God something else.
Life is good.
There's only about 8 of us here, but we feel powerful. Okay, we're going to segue right into optimism.
Ain't God something?
And be aware, we know what an optimist is. An optimist isn't a person that doesn't think there's any issues. An optimist is an individual that knows there's a solution to all issues. So this is the optimistic. You hear that beat? You can turn it up. Yeah, I like this. No matter how hard reality seems, just hold on to your dream. As long as you keep your head to the sky, you can win. As long as you keep your head to the sky, you can win. As long as you keep your head to the sky. Be optimistic.
If things around you crumble,
when things around you crumble and fall,
no, you don't have to stumble and fall.
You don't have to stumble and fall.
Keep pushing on and don't you look back.
Don't keep pushing on and don't look back. That's what she's singing. Inspired when you lift your head.
Reach higher and higher.
Never say never. Be of good cheer. Smile your head to the sky. Come on. My, my, my. As long as you keep your head to the sky, you can fly. As long as you keep your head to the sky. Oh, I love it. I love it. I love life. Think to yourself right now, I love life and life loves me. I love life. Life loves me. Oh, I want you to to feel it with me. Don't leave me up here by myself. I'm okay. But this is a collective consciousness that's all around the globe. Keep your head to the sky. Be optimistic. Your head to the sky. You can have it. Okay. You can download that song and have it for yourself. You can download Life is Good and have it for yourself. We're going to move into prayer right now. And there's no difference between this and prayer. Because you know what prayer is? Opening up the gates with praise and thanksgiving. As long as you keep your head to the sky. So we let the music fade right now. And we come into an awareness. Keep that smile. Keep that heart open. Come into the consciousness of gratitude and thanksgiving and dynamic appreciation of life itself. Just begin to think to yourself of all, everything that you can be grateful for. The mind may have temporarily become clouded with fear of how to survive. But right now, you're taking your mind back where a thought may have had you, where your mind may have been hijacked. You're taking it back now. You're a sovereign being, a cosmic sovereign being. And now you can place it on something to be grateful for. Oh, I'm so grateful. Think about somebody you love right now, or somebodies you love. Think about, just be grateful for them. And in this consciousness of love, this consciousness of gratitude, look what happens. Your perceptual windows become clean and clear. The dawning of a new bright idea begins to unfold within you. This spiritual sun that's within you, always at a 45 degree angle, it's within you. You are the light. Ha ha! The light that lights up every man, every woman, every being that comes into the world. And so in this consciousness of gratitude and thanksgiving, we feel our ability to see the presence that's invisible, yes. I'll always remember moving through the jungles of Africa and noticing as I was with these powerful shaman that had put me through this particular experience. And as we were leaving the jungle, everything was bright as sunlight. It was at night, but the leaves were shining, the ground was bright, and the foliage was luminous. God was shining through everything. Moses had a good day. That bush wasn't shining just at that moment. The bush was always aglow with the light of God. And I saw it. God is everywhere. And we're one with His presence. Feel it in your bones right now. As I am, the great I am presence. I am speaking this word for each and every individual tuning in right this moment, knowing that where they are, God is in God's fullness. And this divine presence is so coursing through their spiritual veins and every organ, action, function of their body temple, their mental body, their emotional body, their subtle bodies are now coming into an alignment with the grand celestial body and wholeness and wellness and well-being and vitality, and is absolutely rising up in them right now. Anything that heretofore would have delayed, denied, obstructed the fullness of life from flowing through these beings that are tuning in right now, oh, it has no power here, because there's only one power, the power and the presence and the love of God that's now active in their consciousness. Mighty miracles are now happening. Oh, you've been writing me about some of your miracles, and I appreciate it. Mighty miracles are happening right now in individuals' lives. ways out of no ways. I'm stepping into the awareness right now. I'm rising into the awareness. Swallowed incorrectly for a second, but that's all right. Of the consciousness of all needs met. Oh, can you grab that? That frequency? What does it feel like to have all of your needs met? Let your mind go there right now. Let your heart go there. Let your mind follow. All of my needs are met. If you're right there at home and you're with some people, just say it out loud. All of my needs are met. There's nothing wrong with saying that, even if there's no visible manifestation of it yet. How do you think it's going to manifest? Feel into it. All of my needs are met right now. Well, I'm speaking the word now for each and every individual tuning in right now, knowing there's an activation going on, that all needs met consciousness being activated. That's called harmonizing prosperity. That's called abundance. That's called opulence being activated. And all of this is occurring right now, individually and now collectively, as a consciousness known as the Agape Nation, which is a dogma-free zone. Oh, Infinite Spirit, Lord God Almighty, how great thou art, and how wonderful is thy divine, holy, holy name, thy perfect nature in us and as us. How great thou art! I speak the word for our freedom, our soulful liberation, and our strength to keep our back straight, our head held high, with supernal confidence. Radiating the light, the brilliance, and the joy that does not come from the world, but comes from our connection from the presence of God. Feel into that. Ray, give them a little taste for them to feel. A little. Don't give them too much. I don't know if they can handle too much. But just give them a taste. I'm going to blow any circuits out here.
If you're perplexed beyond reason, total confusion in your mind, pay heed to simple sign and season, fund for the feelings you find. Send yourself a message as of courage, courage to conquer the past. Fall back from thoughts that discourage, make sure they never last. When it seems like life is useless, seems to you that you are too, you will find strength for the struggle. Inspiration, motivation from the source in you. The sun will rise, don't you ever doubt. Sun will rise, you can work it out. Sun will rise, warming your fear away, all the way. The sun will rise, giving hope again. Sun will rise, giving strength again. Sun will rise, bringing a new day. The sun will rise, bringing a new. Bringing a new day.
Yes. Brother Ray is saying, don't worry about tomorrow. He's saying that the sun will rise, bringing about a new day. And you know when that is? That new day is right now.
Right here, right, right.
right here, right now. Right now, right here. Right here, right now.
Sun's rising.
Rising.
So
rising.